Hey guys, this is David Kwan, and as the title of the video suggests, this video is about my student debt situation. I think the message of this video is really, the title is pretty self-explanatory. It is my response to kind of the reactions that I've been getting regarding my student debt situation. I know it's pretty crazy, right? I've been getting crazy reactions from people, and I understand that reaction. Graduating college, and then right after that, realizing the fact that I owed Citibank $105,000 is a pretty crazy fact. But that's really the fact that I wanted to share and how that came to be. Previous videos, really, I didn't make any opinionated statements. But just to share that fact, how it came to be. And then I made another video kind of giving you guys an update of the situation that Citibank sold two of my loans to Discover, and now I've been able to pay back a good amount. And now, at that time, I owed Citibank and Discover a sum total of $93,000. Currently, and this is now an update, currently, this is an estimate, I owe Citibank and Discover about $68,000. And so, this is what? About 3 years, it's almost 4 years actually, almost 4 years after graduating from New York University with a bachelor's degree in social work, this is now my student debt situation. So that's the update, and it's been interesting the reactions I've been getting from people. You know, it's a lot of, like some people, you know, just like, oh my gosh, it's a huge number, I understand, you know, but telling me to flee the country, start my life over in China or Korea somewhere. That's been interesting to see. People joking, you know, it might be not be a joke, but people joking, I need to like become a prostitute and just whore myself out for money and being this debt slave now. The amount of money I understand is huge. I actually expected more people to kind of be in my situation from the commenters, but if they are, those commenter people have been the minority. But I'm glad if they're in the minority. I'm glad. I hope I'm the minority. I know the average student debt right now is about $22,000, which is really high to me. That's still really high considering that in 2004, the average debt was about 10,000 or 12,000, around there. So it's doubled in the course of a few years, which is troubling and problematic. So yeah, the amount is problematic, but the reaction I feel like is weird. A lot of the reaction, another sort of reaction is just like, oh my gosh, I'm sorry you're such a bad situation. I feel really bad for you. There's a lot of apologizing, a lot of sorry. I feel bad for you. There's that, which I'll get to, you know, further on in this video. So this is, that's weird to me. And then there's a set of reactions, which is just like, just fuck the banks, fuck the government. Don't pay it back. You know, there's a movement of defaulting. You should just default. Not worry about it, you know, the banks are fucking everyone up, they're the criminals, they don't deserve to get their money back. So there's those kind of reactions, because it's, on some level, I do agree, but that's those kind of reactions that this video is really kind of responding to. For the people feeling sorry and bad for me, it's I appreciate the sentiment, but really it's kind of misplaced, because it's not like, it's a horrible situation to be in, sure, and it's challenging to be able to make such huge monthly payments because the loan amount that I have is so huge. It's not an easy thing to owe private banks $105,000 in total. Not an easy thing, but it's not like I didn't know what I was. It's not like I didn't expect the numbers to be that way when I graduated. I took out a loan on my second year, you know, to be about 30,000. Third year was about 30,000, and fourth year was about 35,000. So add that all up with interest, it comes out to be about 105,000. I'm not really that great at math, but that wasn't like a huge surprise that was the case. What was a surprise were the life circumstances that happened to me after graduating, and getting a job because of having to help my parents move to Tennessee and all that crazy shenanigans. My grace period ended before I could even get a job. That was the problem, really. But I knew that, like, once I get a job, I would have to sacrifice a good portion of my income to paying this loan back every month. That I had no doubt about. So, if you're feeling sorry, it really should have been, you should have been feeling sorry because I was unemployed, not because of the loan situation. Because the loan situation, like, if I had a job after a certain point, which I did, and after that, it was no problem anymore. But being unemployed is a sorry thing. Having this huge loan debt is something that everyone should avoid. But once I got here, it's how I got here. You know, what can I do about it other than to tackle the situation? So that's that. The thing about defaulting, with student loan, it's not possible. You can default, but that doesn't solve anything. You still carry that loan with you. Student loan is one of those really persistent ones. You really can't get rid of it unless you die. And I don't plan on dying just to get rid of a student debt, you know. But that's not even the issue. Like I said, I took out this loan expecting the number to be that big. The number didn't surprise me. It's a pretty crazy figure. But that's not the problem. So if I'm able to pay it back, if I'm able to make the monthly payments, I'm making it. I have no excuse not to if I'm able to make it. You know, it's the idea of being like, oh my gosh, $105,000, that's a huge amount. I'm backing out of paying this. The idea is to me a bad idea. I just can't get behind that kind of idea to me. If I'm able to make the payment, I'll make the payment. The question is, what will I do, or how will I make it so that I can make the payment? Also, another thing that was not expected, that was really disappointing, was the inflexibility of, and I think I talked about this a little bit in the previous videos, the inflexibility of banks. They tell you that you're to pay them back in 10 years. The 10-year plan, right? But I wanted to suggest to them, this is my situation right now. I have this part-time job. It's not paying me enough money, because I was a tutor for a while. It's not paying me enough money to make these monthly payments. If I can refinance it so that I will pay, you know, it's a 15-year plan or a 20-year plan, you can raise the interest up a bit. I don't care. But just allow me to have a minimum monthly payment that is much significantly smaller. So I have to pay you like $400 a month. I could do $400 a month. Could you allow me to do that? And the answer from Citibank, of course, was no. Private banks tell you this is the amount of time you have to pay us back, and that is it. That was a huge problem for me. But the issue of this huge loan, like the video says, the message here is simple. This student debt is my responsibility. And of course, I will be reaching out to as many people as I can in my life to pay this back. And in the process, I will owe the people that I love, and I will try to my best to, you know, appreciate and pay them back for how they helped me. But ultimately, I do want to pay all of this back, and hopefully I can do the 10 years. So far, as I've told you, so far I am about $67,000 in debt, which in 4 years' time, to me, that is a significant progress. It's still a huge amount of money. It's still a huge amount of money, but it is much less than it was before, and it can't be done. It really can't be done, and really, I am fortunate. I'm fortunate to have parents who are able to support me. I was fortunate to, for a while, a good while, I had a job that helped me pay for it. And I'm currently unemployed, but I will be entering graduate school in a couple of months, in which case I could defer paying back until I graduate. And then after I graduate with the master's, then it's going to be a whole other ballgame. But really, that's really all I want to say is to say to, because the excuse here is banks are horrible, right? I do understand that banks like Bank of America and Citibank and Chase, they all do crazy shenanigans stuff. I mean, the stuff they did, the things they did is part of why we had this financial meltdown in 2008. And we have this recession that we're trying to recover from. You can almost say that these banks are kind of like, the things they've done are kind of criminal. But whether they're criminal or not, in my opinion, it doesn't excuse me from the fact that I have this contractual obligation to pay them back. They allowed me to use their funds, which helped me fund my college education. And to just back out of that, to me, is really, there's a line of being ethical and unethical, and backing out of this debt crosses that line into being unethical. And that's a problem for me. And, you know, it might seem like it's such a difficult, crazy thing to do to try and pay back $105,000 with a degree in social work, which is not a high-paying field. Might seem like a stupid thing to do, and it might have been, but that was where my passion was, and this is how it happens now. So, really, it's not a question of backing out or not backing out. That's never been the question. The question really is, how? And I've been trying to answer that in my own way, and been making a good amount of progress here and there. I've had some setbacks here and there, but that's really the thing that is important to me, because if I back out of this, then that really is a problem. That could become a big downfall in society. Because imagine if it wasn't just me, because a lot of people have humongous loans. If a lot of people out there are just being like, I need to go to college and college costs this much, and I'm gonna take out loans. I'm graduated. Holy crap! Now I have to pay back $100,000 or $105,000 or $150,000 or $60,000 or $20,000. This is such a huge amount of money. I don't know how to handle this, so I'm not gonna pay it back. If a lot of people in our society started doing that, and they already are, have started doing that. Gosh, like that does a major harm to the overall society, and I don't want to be a part of that. Is my thing. Don't want to be part of something that really hurts the overall society because of my action or because of my inaction. So that's why it's important for me to try as best as I can to pay this back. The concept of default to me is still weird, because it's like the banks are wants to punish you for not paying them back in time, but it doesn't absolve you of your responsibilities. So I don't know. Defaulting is a weird concept to me. The root issue, though, after all this talk about student debt, the root issue really is the cost of higher education. College education, getting a college degree, should not cost this much. That's really the problem. I know Congress right now is trying to remedy the problem of trying to pass bills to make it easier on people with high government loans, not private loans. Their laws will not affect me at all. But government loans, like Sallie Mae loans and such. That's an interesting concept. I do like what Elizabeth Warren is proposing. I think it's a good step. But really, that's just remedying a symptom of the problem. The actual problem is the cost of education. We need to get that lowered. And that is really the issue. But that's a topic for probably a different video if I ever talk about it. But yeah, that's really all I wanted to say. I know this is a long video as usual. Yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed it. Cheers.